With me now is four-time presidential candidate, consumer advocate, and author of Return to Sender, Ralph Nader. Ralph, so glad to have you back.
Thank you.
Is Trump agreeing essentially with President Obama?
Oh, that's quite different. What he just said about high salaries of the bosses and the cushy relation with their board of directors resonates with the left-right reaction all over the country. That's why they're going to be at all left-right people in Dallas, 20,000 people. People want Wall Street crooks to put away, you know, prosecuted and convicted and jailed after 2008, 2009. So the Main Street versus Wall Street is a powerful theme for Donald Trump, and he's got it all by himself. The others are not going in that direction.
Ralph, as you said, he seems to be tapping a lot of anger and a lot of frustration. Do you think he can carry this all the way through?
Well, it depends. If he stays on the offense, he's going to have a lot to say that's going to resonate with left-right against the plutocracy.
It's
or the
anti-establishment.
The big guys. Yeah. If he ever is put on the defense, then all this research that's being compiled by his adversaries in the Republican establishment about his past business dealings, his personal issues, all that will start pouring in on him. So he's got to stay on the offense. It's almost like his polls that are so favorable to him are mesmerizing and distracting the media. So they keep focusing on the polls and on his statements that no one else wants
to
make.
To your point, Ralph, I had somebody the other day say, you want to do something interesting? Get Donald Trump to release his tax returns, and then a real conversation begins. But on that note, we did some math here. So the Trump Organization, I'm just looking at my notes, made between $275, $325 million last year in profits. It was on about $600 million of revenue. So one company we found with similar stats is based in Johnson City, Tennessee. It's called NN. It makes steel balls. The CEO of that company has an annual base salary of $500,000. Trump declared his income as $362 million last year. So when you talk about getting into the numbers, how does that make him look? Does that make him look inconsistent, or does it make him look hypocritical?
Well, he'll interpret it that he did it all by himself. He wasn't relying on a cushy board of directors to rubber stamp his huge income. But, you know, Romney delayed releasing his tax returns for months and didn't seem to pay a penalty. I think he's going to resist releasing all his financial information and see how long he can take it. Right now, his impact on the other 16 or 17 candidates is going to thin out the Republican parade. Governor Perry's just dropping out. I think the impact of Trump taking the oxygen out of the others will reduce the number of candidates down to 8, 7, and then 6. But I do think he gave up his Trump card a couple weeks ago when he said he wasn't going to consider running as independent, and he signed this pledge to stay loyal. He might have done that a couple months too early, Deirdre.
You mean he lost a little bit of leverage? It's so funny, though, because as you're right, Ralph, everyone is talking about this.